And if we do something that the U.S. doesn't like, then of course the U.S. may put a ban on our exports to them. So we are very frightened. In fact, the whole world is afraid of this bully called the United States. They know what the United States is doing is wrong, but no one dares to take action against the United States. Especially as if you take action, you will be alone. You'll be isolated. So nobody dares to come together to take action against the United States because of fear. There will be no mass demonstration against the United States. I mean, sending a small group of people to the U.S. Embassy in Kuala Lumpur is really not helping any. What we need to do is to have persistent demonstrations all over the world, just like the ones you saw in Egypt, for example. That will require massive organization, and I think the Muslim world especially cannot work together in order to organize such a demonstration against the U.S. So I'm sorry to say, but the world's leaders are really skeptical of the United States and will not do anything to annoy the United States. It's difficult to predict the future for the Palestinian people. I still see very little hope for them. But with the things happening in Egypt, which for some reason that I cannot understand, had been hostile even to Gaza and to attempts to help Gaza, much less Palestine itself. I do hope that with the new government, which would replace the government of Hosni Mubarak, the new government will be more sympathetic towards attempt to help the Palestinians. So if we can at least help the Palestinians live a normal life, at least they will be better off than they are today. But as to their liberation, as to their being free from oppression by the Israelis, that is something that will depend on actions such as making war a crime. If we can make war a crime, then even the United States must abide by international law. So if they cannot use force, then there is some hope for the Palestinian. Otherwise, you are going to see these great powers use their military strength in order to oppress their Palestinians. And in that case, of course, the future would be very dark for the Palestinians. Thank you. We should send to them food, medicine, and even construction material. This is extremely important. I think very soon the Israelis will realize the importance of the aid we are giving to Gaza. At this moment, the whole sewerage system in Gaza was destroyed by the Israelis, and raw sewage is now floating into the Mediterranean. As you know, Gaza's beach is just next to the Israeli beach. So that waste, raw sewage coming from Gaza, will soon be polluting the beaches in Israel. And then they will understand why Gaza should be given proper aid, proper facilities, so that they will not have the spin-off or the fall-off from the what is happening in Gaza. We should help the Gaza people, we should help the Palestinian people, we should ensure that they keep up the spirits and continue to resist this injustice that is perpetrated on the peoples of Palestine. Maybe one day we will succeed, we cannot know. But people have been known to change their perception of things, to change their minds because of constant harassing by freedom fighters, for example. That is why we must never give up in this struggle even though the future looks very, very black for the Palestinian people. We mustn't give up. Thank you. Thank you, Yamal.